Hello, my dear students. Myself, Mrs. Dipali Jori, lecturer at KK Wagh Polytechnic, Nasik. Once again, I welcome you all in the online lecture series of Basic Mathematics. In today's video, we will continue with the topic matrices. It's a second video of matrices topic. So now today, in today's video, we will discuss about the algebra of matrices. What is mean by algebra? Algebra means how to add, subtract, multiply or divide. Okay, so again, let's see what is the learning outcome of this video first of all. So after watching this, you will perform algebraic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, etc. in matrices. The division is not included here because division is not possible, is not allowed in matrices. Okay. Now let's start with the first type of algebra, that is scalar multiplication. So what is that scalar multiplication means? Let's see. If k is any scalar or it's a constant and capital A is any matrix, then the product k into A, that scalar multiplied with that matrix, is called a scalar multiplication. Let's see one example. See, if your A matrix is of order 2 by 2, let's consider a matrix of order 2 by 2, a square matrix. Then what is that scalar multiplication 3 into A? 3 is a scalar or it's a constant. So how to do that multiplication? Let's see. So 3 into A is simply, you have to multiply each and every element of that matrix by that scalar. Yes, what is mean by the scalar multiplication? You just have to multiply that scalar or that constant or that number with each and every element of that matrix. So 3 into minus 1 is minus 3 here. 3 into 2 is 6. 3 threes are 9 and 3 ones are 3. You have to write those elements at their respective positions. Let's consider one more example, that is a matrix of order. What is the order of this matrix? It is a matrix of order 3 by 2. 3 rows and 2 columns are there. So it's a 3 by 2 rectangular matrix. Now if you want to multiply that matrix by minus 2, so what we have to do? We have to multiply that each and every element of A, this matrix, by minus 2. So minus 2 into 2, it is minus 4. Minus 2 into 1, minus 2. Multiply each and every element by minus 2 just. Minus 2 into minus 2, it becomes plus 4. Minus 2 into 4 is minus 8. That way, you have to do the scalar multiplication. The next type of algebra is addition. How to add two matrices? Two or more matrices can be added only if they have same order. You have to remember it. How to add those two matrices, that we will see afterwards. But before that, you have to remember this condition, that while adding two or more matrices, remember that the order of those matrices should be same. Then only the addition of matrices is possible. So to add two matrices, how to add those two matrices? You just have to add their corresponding elements. So let us consider the two matrices of same order. A and B are the matrices of order 2 by 3. There are 2 rows and 3 columns. Right? Similarly here, first row, second row and 3 columns. So both the matrices are of same order. Now let us multiply them. Now remember, when you will multiply the matrices of same order, you will get the A plus B, a matrix again, and it should be a matrix of same order again. Okay, it should be a matrix of 2 by 3 again. There should be 2 rows and 3 columns after adding those two matrices. So what is that addition? See, A plus B, what we just have to do, we just have to add their corresponding elements. Corresponding elements means what? The elements at respective places. This is your one position, one position, 1 plus 4, okay, then minus 2 get added with this 2. You have to add the elements at same positions. Minus 2 plus 2. Next 4 minus 2. Second row 3 plus 5 minus 1 plus minus 3. So it is minus 1 minus 3. And last 5 plus 1. Okay. And so the required A plus B is again a matrix of order 2 by 3. And what is that matrix? It's 5, 0, 2, 8, minus 4, 6. Here it is. Okay. So while adding two matrices, just remember that the matrices should be of same order. Same logic for subtraction. So to subtract two matrices, again, the order should be same. Two matrices should be of same order. So to subtract two matrices, again, we just have to subtract their corresponding elements. Again, let us consider the two matrices. Now here, I have considered a matrix of order 3 by 2 now. It's again a rectangular matrix. 3 by 2. This is again 3 by 2. Okay, so the order is same. Let's subtract them. So while subtracting these two matrices, you have to subtract the corresponding elements again. So 2 minus 1. Minus 4 minus 3. Next 2 minus minus plus 4 it will be. Okay. 5 minus 6. Be careful when you write those elements. Do write at their respective positions. Minus 1 minus 2. And 3 minus 5. And then subtract or add those elements. You'll get your required 3 by 2 matrix once again. Your A minus B matrix should be again of order 3 by 2. Like A and B. So 1 minus 7, this is 6. 2 plus 4, it becomes 6. 5 minus 6 is minus 1. Minus 1 minus 2 is minus 3. 3 minus 5 minus 2. This way you can subtract two matrices. Now the very important point is matrix multiplication. When you will multiply two matrices, you first have to remember the conditions. The multiplication of two matrices is possible only if number of columns in the first matrix is exactly equal to the number of rows in second matrix. If this statement is true, then only you can multiply those two matrices. What is that statement? Number of columns of first matrix should be equal to the number of rows of second matrix. Now let us consider an example. If A is a matrix of order 3 by 2, B is a matrix of order 2 by 3. Okay, both are rectangular matrices. So what is that condition? Number of columns of first matrix, rows, columns. First number is always for row, second number is always for column, in order also. So these are the number of columns of first matrix, 2. Are exactly equal to the number of rows of second matrix, 2 again. So these two numbers are same. Okay. So the multiplication is possible. Therefore, AB, the multiplication is a matrix possible. And what is that AB matrix then? After multiplying those two matrices, you will get a AB matrix of order 3 by 3. How you can identify the order of answered matrix AB? It is simply equal to 3 by 3. Number of rows of first matrix by number of columns of second matrix. Before multiplication, what we have to check? Columns of first, rows of first. Does these two elements or the numbers are same or not? That you first have to check. If they are same, go further. Again, before multiplying those two matrices, what we have to first identify? We have to first identify the order of AB. After multiplying A with B, you do first identify your AB matrix is of order, is of what order? So it's a matrix of order 3 by 3. So your answered matrix AB, it should be of order 3 by 3 at last. Now let's consider A is of order 3 by 2. Same orders, let us consider. 3 by 2, B is of order 2 by 3. So we can multiply A with B by considering A as first matrix, B as second matrix. Why? Because the numbers, columns of first are equal to rows of second. Okay. So AB is possible. We can multiply those two matrices. From that, let us now see how to multiply. So by multiplying matrices, multiply each row of first matrix with each column of second matrix. The multiplication is quite difficult, but it is not impossible. Remember the way of multiplication. So how to multiply two matrices? Multiply each row of first matrix with each column of second matrix. So in the above case of multiplication is, so the same examples, same two matrices I have copied here. So multiply this A with B. What we have to do? We have to multiply rows of first matrix with columns of second matrix. Now before multiplication, do first identify the order of AB. Of which order your AB matrix should be? It should be a matrix of order 3 by 3. Okay, so it should be matrix of order 3 by 3. Means after multiplying, we must get 3 rows and 3 columns there. So let us first see what is that first element of AB. In multiplication, you are not supposed to multiply the corresponding elements like addition and subtraction. So while multiplying, you have to multiply that row with column. See how to multiply it. 2 into 1, here it is. Plus, this plus sign is by default. It's a sign of expansion. It's a sign of multiplication of matrices. Compulsory, you have to consider plus sign here. So 2 into 1 plus 1 into 3. We are multiplying first row with first column. This is your first row with first column. So the element is at 1, 1 position. Next, first row with second column. So 2 into minus 2, here it is, plus 1 into minus 1. This is the number after multiplying first row with second column. Next, again first row with third column. Do finish first row first. Okay, first row with every column. So last, first row with last column, third column now. So what is the multiplication? 2 into 4 plus 1 into 5. Okay, this way. Now let's go for the second row. Second row with every column. The elements will come into second row. So let's multiply second row with first column. So 3 into 1 plus minus 1 into 3. Next, 3 into minus 2 plus minus 1 into minus 1. 3 into minus 2 plus minus 1 into minus 1. Second row with second column. Last, second row with last column, 3 into 4 plus minus 1 into 5, 3 into 4 plus minus 1 into 5. Next, last row with every column. In similar way, you have to multiply last row with every column. 1 into 1, 2 into 3, 1 into minus 2, 2 into minus 1, 1 into 4, 2 into 5. Okay, that way you have to write the elements first in the into this form. Then do the addition subtraction and your final answer will be this matrix. It's a matrix of order 3 by 3. So be careful when you will multiply the two matrices. We do take care of signs there. Okay, so here we'll stop. Thank you and happy learning. If you have any doubt, do text me or ask me. Thank you once again.